I'm going to show you how Jude and 2 Peter are so similar. In fact, I believe that one copied the other. It's not just like they both have the same theme. It's not like they both say the same things, but they both say the same things in the same order. On the right side here, I've got the book of Jude. And on the left side, I've got the book of 2 Peter, starting at chapter 2. So let's look first at the book of Jude, and we're going to start with verse 4. For there are certain men crept in unawares, who were before of old ordained to this condemnation, ungodly men, turning the grace of our God into lasciviousness, and denying the only Lord God and our Lord Jesus Christ. Now let's look over to 2 Peter chapter 2, verse 1. Peter said, But there were false prophets also among the people, even as there shall be false teachers among you, who privately shall bring in damnable heresies, even denying the Lord that bought them, and bring upon themselves swift destruction. Look again over at Jude verse 4, denying the only Lord God over here, okay? And again, 2 Peter chapter 2 talks about denying the Lord that bought them, okay? Now, skip on down here to verse 6 in Jude chapter 1, and then 2 Peter chapter 2 verse 4. Jude says, And the angels which kept not their first estate, but left their own habitation, He has reserved in everlasting chains under darkness unto the judgment of the great day. Now, 2 Peter chapter 2, verse 4 says, For if God spared not the angels that sinned, but cast them down to hell and delivered them into chains of darkness to be reserved unto judgment. As we continue, notice how not only the same things are said, but also in the same order. Now, you will notice here that 2 Peter adds a lot more filler in between the concepts, whereas Jude is a lot more condensed, a lot more summarized. Let's continue. Jude, verse 7. Even as Sodom and Gomorrah and the cities about them, in like manner, giving themselves over to fornication and going after strange flesh, are set forth for an example, suffering the vengeance of eternal fire. Now over to 2 Peter chapter 2, verse 6, and turning the cities of Sodom and Gomorrah into ashes, condemn them with an overthrow, making them an example unto those that after should live ungodly. Striking similarities so far, it's going to get even more. Jude, verse 8, likewise also, these filthy dreamers defile the flesh, despise dominion, and speak evil of dignities. Now again, 2 Peter chapter 2, verse 10. But chiefly them that walk after the flesh in the lust of uncleanness and despise government, presumptuous are they, self-willed. They're not afraid to speak evil of dignities. Let's go over to Jude, verse 9. Yet Michael, the archangel, when contending with the devil, he disputed about the body of Moses, dare not bring against him a railing accusation, but said, The Lord rebuke you. 2 Peter chapter 2, verse 11, whereas angels, which are greater in power and might, bring not railing accusation against them before the Lord. Jude, verse 10, but these speak evil of those things which they know not, but what they know naturally as brute beasts, in those things they corrupt themselves. 2 Peter chapter 2, verse 12, But these, as natural brute beasts, made to be taken and destroyed, speak evil of the things that they understand not, and shall utterly perish in their own corruption. Notice the similarities here. In Jude, naturally as brute beasts, whereas in Peter, natural brute beasts. We have in Jude, the things that they know not. We have in Peter, the things that they don't understand. We got in Jude, they corrupt themselves. We got in Peter, to their own corruption. Very, very similar. Jude, verse 11. Woe to them, for they have gone in the way of Cain, and ran greedily after the error of Balaam for reward, and perished in the gainsaying of Korah, or Korah. These are spots in your feasts of charity when they feast with you, feeding themselves without fear. Now, in 2 Peter chapter 2, verses 13 through 16, and shall receive the reward of unrighteousness, as they that count it pleasure to riot in the daytime. Spots they are and blemishes, sporting themselves with their own deceivings while they feast with you. Notice Jude says they feast with you. 2 Peter says they feast with you. 2 Peter chapter 2, verse 14, having eyes full of adultery, and that cannot cease from sin, beguiling unstable souls, a heart they have exercised with covetous practices, cursed children, which have forsaken the right way and are gone astray, following the way of Balaam, the son of Bozor, who loved the wages of unrighteousness. Notice how these books parallel each other, how they talk about the same things and even use the same terminology. Back to Jude, the last half of verse 12. Clouds they are without water, carried about of winds, trees whose fruit withers without fruit, twice dead, plucked up by the roots, raging waves of the sea, foaming out their own shame, wandering stars to whom is reserved the blackness of darkness forever. Now going over to 2 Peter chapter 2, verse 17, these are wells without water. Notice over there, Jude, it says clouds without water. 2 Peter says wells without water, clouds that are carried with the tempest. Just as Jude says that clouds are carried with the wind, Peter says to whom the mist of darkness is reserved forever. Just as Jude said, to whom is reserved the blackness of darkness forever. Now let's go on here to Jude verse 16. These are murmurers, complainers, walking after their own lusts. Their mouth speaks great swelling words, having men's persons in admiration because of advantage. Now, 2 Peter chapter 2, verse 18, for when they speak great swelling words, again, the same terminology here, of vanity, they allure through the lusts of the flesh. Again, see how Jude talks about lusts, whereas Peter talks about lusts, through much wantonness, those that were clean escaped from them who live in error. Jude, verse 17, but beloved, remember the words which were spoken before of the apostles of our Lord Jesus. Now, Peter carries that concept over in 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 2, when he said that you may be mindful of the words which were spoken before by the holy prophets and of the commandment of us, the apostles of the Lord and Savior. Now, going back over to Jude, verse 18, how that they told you there should be mockers in the last time, who should walk after their own ungodly lusts. 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 3, knowing this first, that there shall come in the last days scoffers, which is synonymous with mockers, walking after their own lusts. Finally, Jude, verse 24, he says, now unto him that is able to keep you from falling and to present you faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy. And Peter carries that over in verse 14 when he said, wherefore, beloved, seeing that you look for such things, be diligent that you may be found in him in peace, without spot and blameless. Now, I don't think this is coincidence that in 2 Peter and Jude, you see the same concepts, the same terminology, in the same order. But the question remains, who copied who? Let me know what you think in the comments. Maybe you think that they weren't copied. Maybe you think that it was just a coincidence. Let me know what you think. Was it Jude that copied Peter, or was it Peter that copied Jude?